Hello guys, this is Charles1K92, also known as Geno65, on the PlayStation Network. Continuing off where we just left off, we are going to be completing off everything that's in this area. So, gathering all the treasure chests is one of the main priorities. And also, I also want to show you guys all the feather locations that are in this part of the town. So it doesn't mean that we'll be going like in a particular motion, so I think that we should start going by perhaps seeing an old friend. So I will be marking these on the map as we go along, so if you do get this game and you want to complete it, you can use this video as a reference and a guide, and I will be doing this as we go through each new city.
Varieties brought back from the marshlands of the Indies will heal almost any
ease. Seems quite alarmed.
Don't like the look of that one.
He's gone.
That could be our man.
Oh, that is
better. So this is the first feather of the day, just near Leonardo's workshop. And there is 100 of these. Let's move on to the second feather location. Should be... I know it's near this treasure chest that's thing, so we're going to put it there. So let's climb up this. Double back on ourselves. And we'll keep moving on. Now, many of you might turn around and say, well, how come this is relevant? I mean, why do we even need to do this? What's the whole point? The point is that you get to unlock something if you obviously complete everything. This one is just up here. Third one should be after the tailor shop. I know I'm going quite quick, but you know, it's best that we just get over there and things. So you can just about see it. It's roughly on the same thing. So some of these feather locations are on top of cranes because whatever the reason. Okay. 3. And then the fourth one is, where is it? I think it's there. Oh boy, shouldn't have done that.
You should spend more time in God's house.
Yeah, I don't think I should go into God's house, to be honest. But I have to be careful as well, because health isn't like a thing. Well, we can hear it. But where is it? Aha! A bird must have made its nest from that window. Now, number 5 is... I think it's this one. I'm probably not right, but who knows. So far, I've been getting it right. So if you come to a point where you try to find the feather and it doesn't show up, just use Eagle Vision and it sticks out. So I was just slightly off there. The sixth one is definitely on the bridge, because logic. Thank you. Now, before you guys turn around and say to me this, there's no way that Ezio can swim in the game. He can. So, if at some point I dive in the water thinking, you idiot, what have you done? Don't worry. Now then, the eighth one is back at the Palazzo della Signoria. So before we do this, I'm just going to come down here. Now also, you will find that there are some gondolas which will have these markings over them. These also have money. Not a lot sometimes, but at the end of the day, it's money. Okay. So we're just going to make our way up.
A small tax shall be imposed for the stop all back here, sailing into the main.
Alright, now there is another feather that's also quite close to us, only because that the new area is opened up. Oh, I'm an idiot. Ooh. Did not want that to happen. Oh no, this isn't the good stuff. This is just how an assassin should usually just go around, just randomly jumping off buildings. Okay. Luckily the guards aren't on show today. Right. Alright, so at this point we now have 8. So I could go and grab that one that's over there. That will make it 9. But in order to kind of go off what I know, technically, it's kind of within this boundary, so I don't want to go and grab it just yet. But this other one is on top of this area here, so we're going to go over there now. Perhaps maybe when I do this little race with the thief. Where is he at? There he is.
I can outrun anyone in this distretto. I hear you're the best. Prove it.
The best, huh? Oh my god, how the hell have I managed that? Thank you.
better now plan the road.
You are not going anywhere.
And
once again sending Firenze a message of contempt.
Whatever is you apparently
gathered. All right, we lost them.
Air for all. Don't listen to the so-called experts.
We're just gonna make our way over there as soon as possible. It's all good, it's all good, it's wonderful. There is a reason, love. It's a beautiful display. Okay, let's keep climbing. And we're nearly there. So, what we've just done is we've just completed, I'd say, a very, very small percentage of the feathers in one city. Okay, there's only a certain area that we can go to. Okay. It's always quite convenient they would have a little bit of construction. Oh yeah, also when it does come down to missions that we can do, there are also side missions as well. These side missions can be, as I just went through to say, like, racing, beating up other guys, and delivery. However, there is another thing as well which comes to mind, is that there's also assassination missions that you get from Lorenzo de' Medici himself. So this will be more relevant once we get this sorted out. Okay, so the only other thing would be just like the chest locations. And then everything else. So, I might leave the chests for another time. You know what, no, because I'm not sure I'll get it sorted out and done with. So if it takes me a while just to like get it all done, then that's it. There's not much I can do. Okay, I'm gonna guess this is another bank, because it looks like there are some guards that are posted outside. Okay, which means it's going to be a bit of a punch fest.
Thank you! Got it!
Come on.
Remember your training! Take this man very, very seriously!
Release me!
Let go!
Ouch.
Get run! Let madness!
I see you show him!
all that problem just to get the money. Alright, now we could go and try and get the codex page, which is what that icon is down there, because in the last episode I wasn't too sure what it was, but it is a codex page. So that's something that we got when we acquired the robes of the assassin, that's along with the broken hidden blade.
I should get help.
These things are quite relevant. Okay. Oh,
I'm just a simple man. Please, sir. I am.
Simple man with simple needs. I don't mean to come off with anything too random. It's just, you know, it helps pass the time. So we're nearly there.
There's top stories. The short supply of wheat from this year's harvest has pushed the price up 6 florins per hundredweight, and the Arno has again flooded near Castel's.
Okay, so this should be the last treasure chest in this area, minus the codex.
Citizens of Pisa, I've held a mass demonstration. Once
it is
again.
Almost criminal to pass by without.
We could get ourselves a large medicine pouch along with the knife upgrade, but we'll wait.
Of course, I understand. Ciao then.
Now usually it's a bit more easier once you go through the game a bit more and you start to learn roughly on how things kind of work. So like you start to develop maybe a slight little technique on how you can get things sort of done quicker. At this moment we have to be the way that we are. Right, so we've kind of got everything, we've got all the chests, we've got all the feathers. There's nowhere else to look in this part of town since it's now finished. The only thing would be is to perhaps once the paints become more of a thing to buy, then we might have to return to the city, probably near late game, I would say. Come on.
Watch yourself.
Run! My recent good fortune finding new suppliers has paid.
So we're just going to ignore the codex page. And just make a breakthrough here. Moving. All right. So here's the thing that I'd also go and show you as well. It seems that one of the icons that Rebecca said was here is actually near the place where we have to go. So it was obvious that this was going to be one of the very first places that we'd actually find it. So let's just synchronize up first, and then we'll actually go through on how to best answer, or let's say, solve the mystery of why these things are here. So, yep, so it's called La Rosa. So, with Rebecca, she says, one of those strange glyphs Shaun mentioned is on this landmark. You should go find it. And obviously, we've got the information based on La Rosa.
I'm sorry.
Quit saying sorry. Sorry. Okay. So, what is this?
There's one of the symbols. What does it mean? It must be there for a reason. Can you take a closer look? Hey! Try using eagle vision. Not good all day.
Wait, that's not possible. This can't be. Hold on. That's computer code. Let me compile it. Oh, shit, it's an encrypted file.
Upload it to my computer. I'm a master at decryption.
I can't! It's only compatible with the Animus itself.
Upload it to Desmond, then. I can't believe this.
Okay.
Hello, this is... They call me Subject 16. Listen, I don't have much time. There's something I have to show you. We have been lied to this whole time. Everything we know, everything we've been brought up to believe, it's wrong. Okay, I've uploaded the evidence, the file that proves it all. But I've split it into 20 pieces and locked each with a code. Can't be too careful. Queen Isabella. No, not her. What century is it? Never mind. I've hidden the code to the first file inside this program. Find it. Find them all. And along the way, you'll begin to see the truth.
What the heck? How did this get inside our Animus?
Oh, the memory core. We transferred 16's memory data from Abstergo into the Animus 2.0. He must have hacked the machine when Vidic left him alone between sessions.
Oh, hold on, wait a second. The signs on the walls in Abstergo, the ones written in blood, those were clues. He was telling us to look for them inside the Animus.
Okay, so these are clues. So if obviously you don't know how to complete this, I will be doing this video anyway. So five of these mythic scenes share a core similarity. Pick them out and you'll begin to see. So the clues are in the name. They share a core similarity. Pick Cupid and Psyche? Nope. Diana? Nah, I don't think Diana. The Fool? Adam and Eve? I would suggest. Hercules in the Garden of Hesperides? Sure. It looks like she's picking something up. Judgment of Paris. Triumph of... Nah. Pardon? pass Kyle and doesn't seem to mean much, does it? Seeing two people jump. But it's called the truth anyway. Whatever this is. Okay. So if we just go back onto the database and we go onto locations, so if we ever come across anything new, it should have that eye icon. So, since we've now got a new part of the city to explore, why don't we take the advantage of this? And who knows, we might see more of these glyphs appear if we actually take our time and view it.
Who requires bleeding?
No, I don't think I'll break my neck.
Impressive move.
Okie doke, so we're just climbing up here, minding our own business.
As God is my witness, this man is a cheat and a liar.
That's not fair. Time to get out of here, because I've got a feeling these guards are not going to be nice. Oh look, we've got another one. We'll take a look at this once we finish climbing.
Holy focaccia! What on earth is he up to?
Oh, I don't know. Something, I guess. So, probably at this point, if you haven't been doing, like, the views and everything else, by when I mean views, I mean, going out of your way to doing the viewpoints, you'll unlock trophies, so you'll, like, go, oh, I like the view, or when you were climbing that tower one, there's one where you have to do the base jump off that and survive, whatever. But here's the next glyph, so let's find out what the puzzle is for this one.
The past. A vast web of connections and interconnections, all ruled by chance. Or is it?
Hmm. 64 squares. Well, it's a bit obvious to find out who this person is. I should know. Because she was once our monarchy, once upon a time. Queen Elizabeth I of England, Peace of Eden, apple number 2. Really? I suppose any one of us that has played Assassin's Creed Unity, that they would all know that a particular someone acquired the Apple of Eden, Napoleon. And then to all of us who did play Assassin's Creed 3 and with the DLC of the Mad King George, it seemed that the President of the United States acquired the same one as well. Again, it doesn't really seem to be that much, does it, with the whole truth videos? After all, they have been broken down and compiled into different sets. But still, we're going to make our journey over.
Am I dreaming me?
Yes, you're dreaming it. Okay, come on. Grabbing a little bit more money.
I've traditional remedies.
Of course you do. Oh, Santa Croce. And ironically, it's the same place that we need to do a viewpoint. There is a feather location over there as well, so I'll remember this when we do, before we leave, I guess. Okay, where is Santa Croce's little marking? Must be somewhere nearby. Did I miss it? Aha, there it is.
Power doesn't die. It's passed on.
Descendants, huh? He carried it with him. Find his inheritance. Now, going on the lines of, let's just say, of conspiracy and everything else, it's up to the individual to kind of make sense of particular things. So if you notice, there's like little markings here, written in a particular language. I think somewhere there is things. This is like somewhat of a cipher code. So if you could somehow understand this, then fantastic. But we're more interested in what this is. So it seems that the President has inherited the Piece of Eden. I'm not sure where this one is, but it's somewhere. Oh, there it is. Piece of Eden number one. And then Gandhi.
Yeah.
It's interesting to know that we can go quite in depth with this. Oh, excuse me.
Laggiù!
Get you there!
Well done!
Get on!
No! No, mamma! Got to get up now!
Yeah, clearly, you know, I have no remorse for people like this. It's just... shit. Okay, so we just need to go and kill. Sure, we can call this killing, because technically that's what it is.
You're not allowed up here. Leave. You shouldn't be up.
Laju, you won't get away.
Release me.
You want me to release you? Okay. It's funny upon how they have to like do their little oh no, someone fell, they're dead. Okay. We're slowly getting there. So we've done all the viewpoints now, and we're just going to head back to the mission and get this done and over with. Nearly there. Just gonna have to take this corner here. Yeah, so if you sprint around long enough, you will actually get a trophy as well. So doing what I was just doing, sprinting uninterruptedly, is a good thing. Come on, guards, leave me alone, disappear.
I think we have the wrong building.
No, this is it. It is a pleasure to make your acquaintance, Messer Ezio. Annetta speaks quite highly of you. I can see why.
I appreciate the kind words, Madonna.
Ti prego, call me Paola.
Thank you for offering your home to my family, Paola.
It was the least I could do. You must be tired. Perhaps you'd...
No, grazie. I can't stay.
Why? Where are you going?
To kill Uberto Alberti.
I understand your desire for vengeance, but the Gonfaloniere is a powerful man. You are not a killer, Ezio.
Spare me the lecture.
But I can make you one.
And why are you going to teach me how to kill?
I'm not. I'm going to teach you how to survive. Come.
Now, before you get the wrong end of the stick here, she's not going to teach him how to suck dick. She's just going to teach him how to kind of be seen but not seen.
Discretion is paramount in my profession. We must walk the streets freely,
seen but unseen. You two must learn to blend like us and become one with the city's crowds. My girls will show you how.
So enter a group to blend.
You can practice with me anytime.
Ooh. So let's find out who this Paola is. Oh, so she's the Madame of the La Rosa. Okay, so what we gather from this is the new idea of blending. So instead of, let's say, doing what Altair did in the first game, where we had to hold X, it's now this. Just simply walk into the crowd, stay with them. And that way you can't be detected. So it makes it much more easier instead of having to literally run past. This skill and trait is carried on throughout the entire the AC game, so, well, not game, I mean more or less franchise, so this kind of feature is used, I think, except in, I would say Unity, but I'd say Syndicate is more profoundly known not to have the trait, since you literally have to buy the skill in order to not be seen, or let alone be detected. You can still use the contextual camera just to be able to see what's going on around you. Please hurry up. Looks like we made it back in one piece without being detected. That's cool.
Bene. Now that you've learned to blend, I'll show you how to use it for more than just moving around. Let's teach you how to steal.
Okay, so hold X and you can walk past someone.
Thief! Thief! Once you've stolen from someone, Ezio, you mustn't linger.
Steal from at least 5 people. So basically you just want to do this. Sprint past and...
You can go now, girls.
Oh, do we have to?
So innocent.
He's cute.
Now that you have learned how to approach the enemy, we need to find you a suitable weapon.
What would you have me use?
Ah, but you already have the answer.
Hey, my father's blade and bracer. How did you get them?
By using the same skills I've just taught you.
It's not exactly in working condition.
I assume you're familiar with Leonardo da Vinci.
Si. But how does a painter factor into this?
He's far more than that. Bring him the pieces. You'll see.
Hmm.
Before I go, one last question, if I may.
Of course.
Why have you given your aid so readily to me, a stranger?
I too know betrayal.
Well, it's time to give Leonardo da Vinci a welcome. Well, not less welcome, more or less a nice hello. And we're also going to get the hidden blade fixed, so that's going to be a bonus. So yeah, we can now roughly hire groups, so we can now technically hire the courtesans, the thieves, and also mercenaries. They're always dotted around somewhere in the city, so if you ever need them, you can use them.
Auditore. Oh. I didn't expect to see you again. What with all that's happened. Ah, where are my manners? Welcome back. Now, how can I be of service?
I was hoping you could repair something of mine.
Of course. Come, this way. Che pasticcio. Tutto santo giorno che cerco. Let me clear a space. All right, let's see it. Fascinating. I don't know, Ezio. Despite its age, the construction is rather advanced. I've never seen anything quite like it. I'm afraid there's not much I can do without the original plans. Mi dispiace. Wait.
What are you doing?
The contents of this page are encrypted, but if my theory is correct, based on these sketches, it may very well...
It may very well what?
Please, sit.
Leonardo,
Remarkable. If we transpose the letters and then select every third... There! It's finished!
Huh? What's finished?
The blade. I managed to decode that parchment of yours. It showed me exactly what to do. Now all that's left is to remove your ring finger.
Really?
I'm sorry, but this is how it must be done. The blade is designed to ensure the commitment of whoever wields it.
Bene. Do it quickly.
I was only having fun, Ezio. Though the blade once required a sacrifice, it's been modified. You can keep your finger.
Incredible.
Yes, it is. Tell me. Do you have other pages like this?
I'm sorry. Only the one.
Listen, if you ever do happen across another one of these, please, bring it to me.
You have my word. And thank you for fixing this.
By order of the Florentine Guard! Open this door!
Just a moment. Wait here.
Hmm.
Are you Leonardo da Vinci?
Si. How may I be of service?
I need you to answer some questions.
Certainly.
I've got a feeling that we're going to have to use our new skill.
What seems to be the trouble?
A witness claims to have seen you consorting with an enemy of the city.
What? Me? Consorting? Preposterous.
When was the last time you saw or spoke with Ezio Auditore?
Who?
Non fare il finto tonto! We know you were close with the family. Perhaps this will help to clear your head. Ready to talk? What about now?
You're gonna regret that, buddy.
Tell me what I...
Done.
Grazie, Ezio.
Sorry about that.
I've grown accustomed to their abuses.
What of the body?
Bring it inside and put it with the others.
Others?
The city gives them to me for research.
So, if you think that's strange, technically it's not. It is actually true. Leonardo da Vinci did get bodies, not gifted to him, but given to him as a knight to learn about the human anatomy. So, this guard is going to become one of those people. So, we're just going to bring you in here.
Oh, see? Like it never happened.
Thank you, Leonardo. For everything.
Anytime. And remember, if you find more of those strange pages, bring them to me. Should they contain new designs, I will upgrade your blade as well.
Of course. Now, I really should be getting back to Paola.
Porgile I miei omaggi.
So, getting these codec pages is actually quite beneficial in the long run. And now we have a weapon to defend ourselves with.
Noble prices for noble wares!
Out of pocket, monsieur. What a shame.
Okay, so what I'll do is I'll end the video here. And we'll start to collect some codec pages. I have been Charles 1K92, also known as GM65. See you in a bit.